Welcome back, or welcome for the first time, to Tier 1 Bikes Weekend Edition 2018 series of the European Racing Series, race number 3 at Milano, episode number 3, which means that it is the race itself. We have got a nice sunny day at Milano with 19 degree temperatures, so quite comfortable, not too hot, not too cold, no indication of rain coming along. We're going to set up the drivers now. In this case, hopefully we're not going to need to do too much on the pit stops. By the way, the intention is to have Sarah do 7.77. So she will be coming in end of 7, end of 14, and then she'll be finished at 21. And that's because, of course, she does not have exceptional smoothness, so we want to balance out her tyre wear. In the case of Gomez, he's going to have a descending number of laps, so he'll do 8, and then 7, and then 6. And the reason for that is he's not great at overtaking, so at least by breaking it up like that, he should be able to get clear air on at least one or two of his pits, so that he can get past people without actually having to overtake them. So we don't need the intermediates. There's no indication of rain at the moment. I'm not really expecting any rain. Sometimes it does rain in Milano at this time of year, but I think we'll be okay on that. We don't need the fast pit stops this time around, so we'll take the performance bonus. We are still not going to have a heck of a lot of performance, contrary to the school of thought where if you just turn up at the race and don't screw up, you're going to get a podium. It doesn't happen. Cannot change the laws of physics. And we do not have the engines to get enough speed on a track like this. So we are just basically going to have to make sure that we make no mistakes, that we take it as smoothly as possible, and that we leave something in reserve at the end which we can punch. And in fact, I'm starting to think that maybe... You know what? I'm going to change that. I'm going to strip an extra 5% off the engine. So that's at 81. That's at 82. So that gives us 249, 274. Yeah. Because the thing is, what I'm going to do, I was originally tossing up whether to do a really thump it sort of race or whether to do a light and tight sort of race. And now I'm going to do something of a hybrid in between. So I'm going to get them to cruise, especially in their second stints, and then try and pound it at the end if the engines are still holding up, which they should do. And if that gives us an extra 15 points, then maybe we'll be somewhat competitive. Okay, so that's the first time I've ever actually weight stripped outside of the practice session. Normally I do all of my weight stripping there, but yeah, I think this is probably going to be the better way for us. Empty slot, again, light-footed mediums, we don't really need that. Quick fixes, hopefully we don't need that, so we'll go for the performance bonus and try to get the performance as far as possible up, because the thing is, like I said, it's all about performance. You can't just rock up and expect a podium. I'm not expecting a podium this time around. Yes, we got one in the first race, but that was a combination of preparation meeting luck. By the time the second race had rolled around, all of the preparation, we'd lost that edge because the other teams had time to catch up, especially with regard to having their parts up to a reasonable level. We had the advantage of a level 2 factory over some of the teams anyway. We had the advantage of having Gary. We had the advantage of juggling our parts probably more efficiently than the others, and also using our mechanics bonuses a little better than the other ones in race 1. And that plus luck is what got us onto the podium there. It didn't get us onto the podium last time around, but it did at least get us over the sponsor objective, and I'm not expecting a hugely successful race this time either. But as long as we don't backslide too much, I can live with that, because this game is a game of pendulums. Your performance will swing. There will be ebbs and flows. Our time is coming. Our parts are coming. We have the necessary infrastructure that a lot of the other teams don't have, and we will build up, but that time is not yet. So we'll just do the best we can with this race. The car strategy, in the practice session, we got a really easy setup with Gomez, and then Thomas was an absolute nightmare, but at least we got one excellent and two greats. I'm not going to change anything about the setups. I'm going to go out with the full tank. I don't think that's always necessarily the best option. It is an option, and there are pluses and minuses to doing it, but I shall do it this time, and in fact, I'll use this opportunity to burn a little bit more in the first stint, but then the middle stint, I'm just going to make it as light as possible. So we're just doing 7 for 7. Tire choice, the softs, as I mentioned in the practice session, if you saw that, if you didn't, this is a reasonably hard track for tires. But even so, the expected range of softs, as you can see, is 10 to 12. We do fuel stints which are no longer than 9. In our case, the longest stint is going to be 8 for Gomez on his first stint. So last year, they were able to last into the 30s by the time we pitted. So I'm not really too fussed about that. I think we can make them last. Last year, some of the cars went out on mediums, but probably a small majority went out on softs. Fuel options will be fine, and confirm that, and the driver strategy. Now I'm going to push them straight up into attack mode, because what I found last year was that the tires don't heat up particularly well or rapidly on this track, so that's what all of the others are going to be doing anyway, I will betcha. Alright, so we are ready to start the race, but I'm just going to do a save first. Valdez and Chu are on the front in softs, or on softs. Rogers. And Dreyfus are on the second row, also on softs. Hong Liao and Luigi Marchetto on softs. El Sadat on softs. But Cristiano Dioste is on mediums. And Faith Anthony and Inez Santa Ana behind are also on mediums. And the sixth row, mediums again. And the seventh row, mediums again. And then once we get to the 8th row, which is Zarate and Mello, softs. 9th row is softs, Sabato and Gomez. Gomez's expected form is 5. Sarah Thomas, expected form of 5. And softs and Amanda Cavalcanti, possibly odds-on favourite, is also on softs with a form of 6. Let's go. Okay, get this up to 2 times to get around a little more. Might zoom out a little so we can get a bit more perspective on things. I'll zoom in later on. Wait until we get around to lap 1 and then we'll have some idea of what's going on. Gomez is in 16th, Thomas has dropped all the way back to 20th, but that's behind Cavalcanti, so that's not too surprising. So Cavalcanti's overtaken her. Cavalcanti seems to be overtaking a lot of people these days. We have just passed lap 1. I let Cavalcanti pass. Andre, don't beat yourself up. It's Cavalcanti. She's doing really well in a really good car at the moment. Tire temperatures are up above the midline, so we can start cranking back a little bit. I'll take you back to push for both of you. Fuel is currently still okay. Thomas is going to be the first one coming in on lap 7, or at the end of lap 7. Damn it, I can't get past Cavalcanti. That's not surprising, but you are now behind Zarate, according to the laps chart up here. Now, let's take a look and see what's happening. So pretty much everybody is still thumping their tyres. A couple have gone back to a neutral stance, but yeah, we seem to be in the lowest mode possible, and perhaps as a consequence, we're at the end. But I'm okay with that for the moment. There's no real point trying to push up to a higher mode. The traffic's still pretty much jammed up, so you're basically pushing against a bit of a brick wall. We shall bide our time and let the race come to us rather than the other way around. We can get back up to 2 times now. Thomas is now on lap 3. What sort of times are we talking about? 1:12.884, 1:13.243 for Gomez. That's not awful. It's not great. They're now both in the 113s, which is even less great. We have lap 4. Okay, so she has 5 and a bit laps of fuel to go. And I'm going to push her up into a high engine mode. I'm going to take her tyres back to neutral. Take Andres back the same way, because they're up in the red zone now. Santa Ana needs to get out of my way. Yeah, well, now you've got Hong Liao to worry about. What's the distance? Less than a second, about a fifth of a second, now about half a second. Can't get past Zarate. You were closing on him a little bit there for a moment. Okay, tire temps are okay, fuel is okay. Andre, you can start pushing the fuel up a little bit too, because there's no point lugging that much around. You are now on lap 6, presumably. You are on lap 6 because we've got focus on you at the moment instead of on Sarah. So Andre will have 2 laps before he comes in. He'll be coming in on lap 8. Times aren't looking too bad at the moment, I don't think. 1:12.643. Back to 1:13s again, but most of the field's doing 1:13s, except for the real heavy hitters up front like Tyler. Ah, okay. Lap 7, Thomas's time to come in. And that's the thing about this race, it's only 21 laps, and they go so fast. So she will have 1.86 at the pit stop. She probably could have burnt a little bit more there, but that's okay. Now we're going to do a light and tight strategy for this next stint, which will be 7 laps for both of them. So that will give her 7 laps of fuel. Part condition is looking okay-ish. Engine's down a little bit, but it's nothing to really worry about at this time. 10 seconds for the pit stop, that's fine. She is around there, so she will be coming in. I want to get past back to standard time when she comes in so that we can get some idea of how she's pitting. So she is coming in now. Who else is in? Marquetta and at least one other. Wheels look okay, jacks look okay, and refueling looks okay. So I'm going to get her back onto a medium engine mode, get her up to push because the tyre temps are probably going to degrade a little bit. Andre, I am going to take a look at now. He is now on lap 8, should be on lap 8. It's time to pit him as well. He is going to get a fresh set of softs. He is going to get 7 laps of fuel, 0.96. That's a little bit more close to where I wanted them to be at this point. It does mean that there's extra time taken to refuel them, but even so, it does mean that they've been going around the track faster. His part condition is looking actually even better than Sarah, at least in respect of the engine and the gearbox. His minor parts are starting to degrade a little bit faster for some reason, but that's okay. No reason to go for anything other than a balanced pit stop this time, because he doesn't have that advantage at the moment with the fast pit stop, so that's fine. Sarah Thomas, how you doing? Andre, yeah, okay, you're fine. Tire temperatures are getting a bit above the middle. I'll leave you on push for a little bit longer. Let's switch across to Andre and see him come in. And here he comes. Okay, so how's this? Jacks look good. Wheels look good. Refueling is always the slowest part, but that's okay. Yeah, that's pretty good. Okay, so I'm going to do the same thing with him. I'm going to push him back onto a medium, and push mode for his tyres to get his temperatures up a little bit. Sarah's temperatures are looking okay, so I'm going to pull her back onto a neutral stance. It's not too cool. What sort of times are we talking about at the moment? For Sarah, we won't have a good time. For Andre at the moment, it'll be his outlap. It's still her outlap too, by the looks of it. Let's get up to 2 times. So Sarah's on lap 9. Well, Andre's on lap 9. I would imagine Sarah's on lap 9 now as well. Should be. Okay, so we should have a flying lap time for her now, which is 1:12.402. It's okay-ish. Gomez must still be on his outlap because he's showing at 1:22.374, which is a little on the slow side. So whereabouts is he? He's coming around to the pit lane now. Once he gets around that corner, he's in 10th place. Yeah, he's behind Sarah. So he's over now, and that time was 1:12.396. Well, it's enough to get us above the sponsor objective, and that's pretty much all I was expecting. Andre's tyre temperatures are just touching on the red zone at the moment, so he can come back to a neutral stance. Everybody has pitted once so far, and it looks like just a small majority of the field is on softs, which is pretty much the way it was last time. So, whereabouts are we at the moment? Sarah is now on lap 12. She's got 2 laps before she comes in. Can't get past Iannizzi. Okay, Sabato is halfway through his tyres, but these are mediums and they have a cliff number of 5%, so that's not going to force him to come in anytime soon. The softs up here, they're about halfway through. We're in a slightly better position. Except for Iannizzi, Strambi and Diosti are starting to wear theirs down a little bit. We're still on two times. I'm going to come back to one time because this race really does... It's only 21 laps. It goes so fast if you're not keeping an eye on it constantly. She's got 1.5 laps to go. She's got more than enough fuel to do it. I hope you didn't hear that. I just needed to take a drink then. All right, so she is now on lap 14, so it is time for her to come in. She's just gotten above the sponsor objective. Beautiful timing. It's not really a concern. Okay, so she is going to have 7 laps remaining after the pit stop. I'm going to fill her up. Yes, it's going to make her go slower initially, but the thing is that she will have 9 laps of fuel to do 7 laps. Now, if she is on high mode, she will be capable of doing, in theory, 7.2 laps because the multiplier for high mode is 1.25. So if I give her a full tank, she should be able to stay on high mode for the entire time. She's going to burn through the fuel faster, she'll get lighter faster, and so hopefully what she loses in lugging the extra fuel around at the start, she is going to gain in drinking through it on her way through. Her engine is at 46%, so we should be able to get away with that. Pit strategy is going to remain balanced. So she is, where is she at the moment? 7th, so she's only just past the pit lane, so she'll be pitting at the end of this lap. Tire temps are okay, fuel is okay. Gomez, you also, your tire temps are getting up a little bit, but they're well within, as long as they're just inside the red zone and not at the top of it, we're okay. So, you will be coming in next time, my friend, and you will be also getting to thump it, but you will have 6 laps to do, so I am actually going to still give you the 9 laps and possibly try to get you to thump it a little harder. But let's see what Sarah's pit is like. Jacks are okay, wheels are okay, fuel is ticking up a little bit. She is now out and on her way. So I'm going to get her into high mode, high engine mode, and push driving style, warm up her tires a little bit, and also see if she can get a little bit of distance. She's coming out of the pits now, so is Marquetta. Andre, whereabouts are you? You are on lap 15. It is your time to come in as well. Change you over for a fresh set of softs. Fuel option, I will fill you up. 0.34, that's exactly where we want it to be. Now, I will fill you up if you have the engine capacity, and you do. 60% is perfect. So we will get you in, and we will get you out on high mode, and then towards the end, hopefully we can get you to really, really thump it. All right, so Sarah still has excess fuel. That's what I like to see. That's what we need to keep an eye on. 8.55 laps. What sort of times are we talking about at the moment? Thomas is doing 1:35. Oh, this is still a round lap. Okay, Gomez is in. Jacks are good. Wheels seemed a little tardy to me, but they weren't too bad. Refueling is taking a while to do. Go, 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 go. Get out of there. Okay, so I'm going to get you up into push and high mode. Sarah, I am going to bring you back onto neutral mode because your tire temps, I want to keep as much in reserve as possible for the last few laps. So she's going to be probably on lap 16 as well now. Andre's on his flying lap out, so his time is going to be irrelevant at the moment. Sarah is 1:22. No, she must still be on a out lap as well. Let's get up to two times and get them both past the finishing line again so that we can see what's going on in terms of their times. Actually, let's get it up to four times and see what's happening. She's still on excess fuel, which is good. Andre's still on excess fuel, which is good. Let's go back to standard time, take a look at the times again. 1:12, 1:06, 1:22, 5:66. What? How can you be doing 1:22, 5:6? Oh, that was his last lap, though. Oh, okay, he's going to need one more lap under his belt. Yeah, he's on lap 17, so his last lap was lap 16, which was his out lap. Okay, that's why. Okay, Hong Liao is in the pits. Nobody seems to be having mechanical issues, or I haven't seen any with mechanical issues. That doesn't necessarily mean anything. Sarah is on which lap? Lap 17. She has just hit lap 18. She's got excess fuel. So she's got three. What's the distance between her and the one in front of it? 2.116. That's not good. Andre, you get up to overtake mode. And maybe bring your tyres back a little bit because... yeah. And Sarah, get your tyres up a little bit because you've still got heat to burn. Get yourself up into overtake mode. I don't like using overtake mode unless you're actually using it to overtake. But... yeah, Santa Ana's in the pits. Hopefully that's going to push Thomas up. Yes, it does. Pushes her into the sponsor objective range. But she's still got a lot of distance to make up. She's going to catch Sidwell. All of the cars in front of us have done their two pits. And, yeah, okay. So we've still got excess fuel on both of them. Thomas is on lap 19. Her tyre temps are okay. Andre's tyre temps are actually... okay, he's over 2 seconds behind one in front of him, so I want him to try to get a move on there. See if he can get up a little bit further. I don't like his chances. It's the Rate. Sabado's halfway through his mediums. He should actually be travelling relatively slowly. Engine, 42%. You're okay, you're fine. 29%, you're less fine. But you should still be okay for the remainder of the... wow, who's that car behind Thomas? Cavalcanti, uh-oh. We may have a problem. Okay, Sarah's still got excess fuel. She's still thumping it, but Cavalcanti is coming on really, really fast. And if she takes over Thomas, we're in trouble because there goes our sponsor bonus. So 110, Thomas is doing 110, Cavalcanti's doing 112. It's not surprising because Thomas is on overtake mode. She's still 2 seconds behind the car in front of her. I don't think there is any chance that she is going to be able to make up that distance. Gomez also. Sabato's on mediums at 1/4. He should be going really, really slowly at the moment, but he's not. And this is where our engines are coming into play. 111.007. There's still excess fuel for both of them. Tyre temps, Andre's all the way up to the top on his tyre temp. There's probably no advantage in leaving him up there. Sarah is pretty close to the top, but she's coming across the finish line now. Anyway, she has finished 7th. That's not as good as I would like. That's all right, guys, not too shabby at all. 11th. That's not what I would call not too shabby, Andre, but we did it as best we can. 0.39 laps, 1.39 laps. Gomez, I possibly could have pushed up a little bit earlier. What's his park condition like? Can we still see that? Yeah, 42%. Would have been a lot more comfortable had Sarah at least been able to get 6th. But 110.791. Not a bad fastest lap, but she was on push mode for a heck of a lot of that. I keep saying it, and I keep saying it, and I keep saying it comes back to engines. On a track like this in particular, high-speed track, that's what it's always going to be determined by. So, Andre, 11th. Let's see whether anybody got pinged by scrutineering. Let's just take a look at some of the other times. 112, 111. Yeah, it's not anything to be ashamed about. But the reality is that the fastest lap does give you an indication of engine strength. But you can see a lot of them are still a heck of a lot faster than, for example, Gomez. Gomez was really, really pounding it out there and still only managed to get 111, didn't get into the 110s. We have all these other cars which probably weren't on high mode for an entire lap and still managed to do into the 110s. We're okay, but did anybody else break the rules? Doesn't look like it. Doesn't look like it. Okay. Sarah has maintained 3rd. Gomez has dropped 2 places down to 5th. We will have lost 1st. There's no doubt about that. We have. We've lost it to Ozu. But we've lost it with only 7 points. And like I said, this is the pendulum game. It is swinging back in our favour. It's going to take us a little while, but we shall return to that top position. Austin Zarate is my hero. Seriously, awesome driver, cool car. Yeah, Austin's alright. Ebony Tyler, Nicholas Thrambi, and Eduardo Mello. really happy with the result today. Shout out to everyone back at Silver Racing. Ebony Tyler, delighted to win at Milano today. We do not make the news this time, boys and girls. Okay, 6.4 for Andre, 4.4 for Sarah. Yeah. We came sixth. That's two below where we were expected to be. And so Thomas's happiness with me has dropped by 6 percentage points to 94%. That I can live with. Our marketability has dropped by less than a percent, but you know how I feel about marketability, so not too pleased about that. Not too pleased at all. Let's continue on. We got the bonus, so it's only 283,000 cost for the race. At least that's something. There's the roundup. We don't need to see that again. Okay, so six pieces of mail, three pit crew things to review, three scouting reports, 24 days to Tondela, and a partridge in a pear tree. That is it for this weekend. It wasn't a bad race. The only thing that I can think of that I could have done a little bit better there was to maybe push Gomez up into overtake mode a little bit earlier so that he burnt through more of his fuel. But it was never going to be our race because we are still... The engines are okay-ish, but remember, second worst in the competition. So I'm content enough with that particular situation. We will start to show what we're made of over the next few races. If you enjoyed this race, please do whack the like button over the head with a hammer. If you have any intelligent, insightful comments to make, which are the vast majority on this channel, please do make them. And if you have not already subscribed, please do so. But that is your bite for this weekend. So until next week, have a great Sunday, remainder of Sunday, and have a great week, and goodbye.